What's news? This isn't. Now we all know about the three biggest parties in UP politics, or rather the two parties and their little kid brother who wants to play with the older kids really, really bad. So it's only fair that we take the time to look at the independent candidates. This year we have three of them running for councilor. Let's start with Carlos Caballero.
Disclaimer, I've known Carlos for years and we're really close friends, so I'll try really hard to be objective.
Of the three candidates, Carlos's platform has the broadest appeal. It focuses on transparency, freedom of speech, and accountability, also known as the characteristics of an imaginary government. One notable thing about the platform is what's not in it, though. Specifically, any mention of free education. Carlos's stance on accessible education has been a sticking point for a lot of people. It's shocking that he's maintained such a strong following despite this, which is kind of like getting cheered in Cal after saying, "Woo, 21 units for GE, make it happen!" Carlos has been garnering a lot of support, not just with his strong platform, but also his charisma as a performer. Nice try, Carlos. It's an election, not Pinoy Boy Band Superstar. Besides, Pinoy Boy Band Superstar is way more credible and clean than UP politics anyway. Whoa, did I just go? Next, we have Paolo Sevilla. Paolo has gotten attention thanks to his Persons with Disability Advocacy that focuses on students who have both physical and mental health issues, a historically marginalized sector both in the university and in the country. But come on, it can't be that bad, right? It's not like when discussing mental health, people just have a knee-jerk reaction to ignore the issue and instead making it about something entirely different.
Ikaw naman, Shari. Maliban dun sa mga nilahukan natin na forums at discussions hinggil sa mental health, maganda rin inuugat. Bakit ba rampant ngayon yung mental illnesses, lalo't lalo na sa mga kabataan? Sa katunayan, reflective siya nung bulok din na sistema na meron tayo sa kasalukuyan. Madalas ma-depress tayong mga kabataan dahil una, wala tayong pambili ng gantong mga bagay. Dahil ikalawa, nandiyan yung inaccessibility ng education. Actually, nagiging primary yan. Dahil patuloy na tumataas yung tuition fees, tumataas yung other school fees, nagkakaroon ng mga balakid para matugunan no yung ating kagustuhang makapasok sa loob ng pamantasan. Nasasadlak tayo sa ganung mga klaseng illnesses. Again, reflective siya nung kasalukuyang sistema at muli, sama-sama natin naman tong ibabaka.
Oh, hi, Shari! Isang militanteng gabi sa inyo! When asked about this quote from Shari during Upfront, Paolo admitted that he hadn't seen the quote firsthand, but if it meant what he thought it did, that whoever said it would not receive his vote. Well, there's the quote in full, Paolo. Feel free to let us know where your vote stands. Or, is it too late now to save Shari? And now we come to the final independent candidate.
The greatest man alive in the world today.
Now, Juan Gonzaga's platform is built around representing the varsity athletes of the university. And as much as we think they're untouchable gods and goddesses walking among us mere mortal, the university's ability to royally fuck people over affects even them. For one, there are the questions of funding, whether it comes to housing and food to extremely expensive surgeries that the athletes sustained while representing the school. Next, there's the UP track oval, or as it looks like now, the African savannah. Tearing down the track oval and still expecting these athletes to train at a high standard is like going up to a novelist crashing his laptop, breaking his pencils and pens, and telling him to finish his book with tears from his eyes.
Or like asking Stan Dupy to answer a simple video question that you posted on your page. Wait, what?
Unfortunately for Joo-wahn, he's been having trouble getting the student body to take him seriously. Now, part of that is because of this. Another part of that is this. Baka sakaling napakikinggan, pag-ibig na pala isipan, sakta na lang idaraan, nag-aabang sa Alright, now, I understand that a candidate shouldn't be defined by the things he does in his free time. After all, His victory in this election won't be dependent on his singing ability or his cooking ability or his luscious, beautiful hair. Oh my God. If I could vote for his hair, I would. What we can look at, however, is that during his term in the University Freshie Council, wherein he received an impeachment case for excessive and consistent absences. Well, of course he was absent, guys. Do you know how much rehearsal it takes to pull this off? Should he win, here's hoping no further reality shows come tempting him. But until then, Joo-wahn Gonzaga's hair is my number one USC counselor.